home of Columbia Pictures and Warner Brothers Studios. Elizabeth Taylor has spent a lifetime in these and other motion picture studios all over the world, making films that have entertained audiences all over the world. Tonight, just below us on stage five, Variety Clubs International have gathered many of Elizabeth's friends and co-workers to share a warm and beautiful evening with her. I assure you that it will be a memorable evening, because by Elizabeth's presence, she is helping underprivileged and handicapped children. I received this honor last year, so I know what it will mean to her and to the children.
Yes, John. Welcome to an all-star tribute to Elizabeth Taylor, starring Robert Blake, Debbie Boone, Tom Drake, Henry Fonda, Frank Gorshin, Monty Hall, Bob Hope, Rock Hudson, Jimmy Lydon, Roddy McDowell, Paul Newman, Carol O'Connor, Dan Rowan and Dick Martin, and Nelson Riddle and his orchestra. Brought to you by Sears Roebuck and Company. Sears, where America shops. From the Atlantic to the Pacific, from border to border, wherever you live, the Sears family all over America is ready to serve you at a Sears store or through the catalog. Sears is where America shops. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. John Wayne.
Ladies and gentlemen, I ask you to join me in welcoming our guest of honor, two-time Academy Award winner, accompanied by her husband, John, Elizabeth Taylor Warner.
With you tonight. People in this town present tributes to each other more often than Farrah Fawcett Majors combs her hair. In Hollywood, anytime someone throws a cloth over a table, 400 people, in formal clothes, immediately show up and start singing, "For He's a Jolly Good Fellow." So, why tonight? What makes tonight any different or any more worthwhile? Two things. Elizabeth Taylor. Clubs International, the big heart of show business. Like John Wayne last year, Elizabeth Taylor makes it possible to continue the work of helping underprivileged and handicapped children all over the world. We've come to have some fun tonight so that some deserving kids can have some fun in nights to come. Elizabeth, in behalf of those kids, we thank you. Before we continue, I'm sure we'd all like to meet the guests seated with you.
Elizabeth is seated with John Wayne and her husband, John Warner. Her daughter, Liza Todd. Spencer Segura. Mrs. Robinson. And her husband, Sugar Ray Robinson. The man who directed Elizabeth in Little Women, Mr. George Cukor. And Elizabeth's mother, Mrs. Sarah Taylor.
Now it's my privilege and my pleasure to introduce a man who truly needs no introduction. I know he's a favorite of yours. He's certainly a favorite of mine, and definitely a favorite of his. A man whose fame is preceded only by his nose. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Bob Hope. Yeah.
Thank you very much. That applause is wonderful. It's much more than I deserve, and considerably less than I expected. I almost didn't make it here tonight. I ran out of gas, and that's not easy walking over from my house. Luckily, I passed a Texaco station. I didn't really mean to pass a Texaco station, but the Texaco people asked me to mention Texaco at least four times. Sponsor or not, I told them I wouldn't be part of any such blatant commercialism. But isn't it wonderful tonight to be in the same room with a woman who's so happily married to such a great-looking, charming man? But enough about Dolores. You have no idea what a thrill it is to stand here and see Elizabeth Taylor sitting there just to the left of John Wayne. But then who isn't? Tell you, it's really something to be here tonight. You know, we're honoring a lady tonight who can lose one earring and upset the nation's economy. It's true. And you'll notice Elizabeth's not wearing all her jewelry tonight. No, but you get a load of that diamond on her finger. It's the only ring I've ever seen with a high and a low beam. Now, let's face it, Elizabeth done well. To give you an idea how well Elizabeth has done, recently Jackie Onassis received a settlement of $26 million, and Elizabeth sent her a Hallmark sympathy card. But you're beautiful, Elizabeth, and I haven't seen such a gorgeous face since this morning when I shaved. You are beautiful. Besides, beauty and glamour, you and I have a lot else in common. We were both born in England, and I don't know why you left, but I left because I found out I couldn't be queen. Of course, the way things are changing in the world today. Now, this wonderful gal, Elizabeth Taylor's on a farm, living on a farm in Virginia, and she's doing very well. And Liz is adapting to the farm very well, but it hasn't been easy. I mean, where do you find a rooster with a 12 o'clock wake-up call? 2, 3, 4. No, it must be some sight to see you feeding the hogs in a gown designed by Edith Head. Although, why a hog would be wearing a gown designed by Edith Head? I guess you all know Elizabeth's husband, John. He used to be Secretary of the Navy, and he still has the old Navy habit. He's got the only farm in Virginia with a poop deck. He says full speed ahead to everything but the rabbits. That's what John says. surprise for you. We didn't announce he was coming tonight because with his busy schedule, we weren't really sure till the very last minute that he could be here. But you're the only one man in this country who needs no introduction. Elizabeth, ladies and gentlemen, may I present to you Haynes George's favorite son, right here. Billy, what's the good word?
Six-pack.
Wait a minute. That's two words.
Not if you drink fast enough.
Billy, I understand you're going into the beer business, all right?
That's right. We settled a deal this morning. I gave him a personal check for $400,000.
You're kidding. You got $400,000 in your checking account?
No, I got $19 in my checking account.
Yeah, but you can't write a check for $400,000 if you only got $19 in the bank.
You can in Georgia.
I understand that Bert Lance has a beer, too, an overdraft. Is that right? Listen, let me ask something. By the way, Billy, what brings you to Hollywood tonight?
I've always wanted to meet John Warner. I hear he might run for the United States Senate. And in case he wins, it'd be nice for me to have a good friend in high political office.
I know, I read Newsweek. And you may need one.
I love Elizabeth Taylor.
Well, don't tell me. Tell her.
Which one is she?
Which one is she?
Don't you know either? But seriously, Miss Taylor, you've given me and my family a lot of entertainment over the years, and we are very grateful. My mother thanks you, my sister thanks you, my brother thanks you, and I thank you.
Let's hear from Billy Connor. Elizabeth, I want to add my own thanks, darling. Thanks for the memories. Your pictures always swell. In movies you excel. And now tonight you're out of sight for helping kids get well. And we thank you so much.
Gentlemen, Mr. Robert Blake.
Now, you see, it is totally appropriate that I should be here. You don't know, see, you just don't know. Elizabeth and I were sweethearts, you see. She didn't know that either. We went to school together a few moons back. All I can remember was how beautiful she was, and she was making national velvet and coming into Miss McDonald's schoolhouse and talking about riding a horse and all like that, and how you almost got your arm broke. And I was saying, how come she can't recognize my enhancing charm, wit, poise, and beauty, and personality? And anyway, you still are very, very beautiful, and I remember you very, very well. And now I'm supposed to say something about people who start out young in the business, you see, because Elizabeth and I started out young in the business. And look what happened. Anyway, tonight we have with us two lovely young folks, Christy and James Vincent McNichol. Yeah. Now also we have with us, and I'm supposed to say something wonderful about him, John Travolta. You see, he's taller than I am, and young and handsome and talented, and he's already a movie star, so what can I say to him except that I like him a lot, and I hope when I'm an old duffer and can't get arrested, he'll give me a job. Now then, we have also another young talent with us that's got a giant, wonderful, you light up my life, you all know you light up my life, and you light up our life, Elizabeth. Debbie Boone.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Carroll O'Connor.
it only take a couple of seconds. I first met Elizabeth back in 1961. She was doing the film Cleopatra in Rome, and I was in that film in a small part. And, of course, we were all very pleased to be in this mammoth production. All the men in Rome were in love with Elizabeth. She was only aware of two, but anyway, we were all mad about her. I remember one, and finally came time that I was to play a scene, play in a scene with Elizabeth. I had no dialogue with her, but I was a Roman senator, and we were in the scene together, and one of the English actors said to me, we had a whole crowd of English actors. They were the only people who the producers imagined could speak like Romans, see. Anyway, they were all there, and one of these English guys said to me, you're working with Elizabeth today. And I said, yes, I'm very pleased to be doing that. She's gorgeous, marvelous. You're very lucky. I said to him, should I make my move? And he said to me, don't be silly, old boy. You haven't even got billing. So, anyway, I always wanted to kiss her, and I'm going to go over and do that now.
Dick Martin.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening, Elizabeth. What a great pleasure.
It certainly was. Moonlit nights, dancing till dawn.
What are you talking about?
Elizabeth and Dick. Surely you've heard our names entwined.
You don't mean to say that you and Elizabeth Taylor...
I didn't mean to say it. It just popped out.
What are you talking about?
Can't say anymore. I'm sorry. It's all in my new book.
In your new book?
Inside Hollywood by Dick Martin.
Oh, yeah.
I tell everything I know.
Oh, it's a pamphlet.
Nevertheless, the secrets of Hollywood are revealed. In chapter one, I tell about the flaming romance between Mae West and Mickey Rooney.
Mae West and Mickey Rooney were lovers? I had no idea that was going on.
Neither did Mae.
I don't want to hear about it.
Neither did Mae.
Let's drop.
That's what Mae said.
I've had enough.
That's what Mickey said.
Talking about Elizabeth Taylor.
Yeah.
She's done some exciting things.
Yes, and don't forget her movies.
Oh, okay. Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf? Warner Brothers, 1966, starring Elizabeth Taylor and Richard Burton. Boy, they were hot then.
Yes, and they were very popular, too.
Oh, yes, as well. About a little night music.
What did you have in mind?
Well, a little dancing. Why, no, a little night music is Elizabeth's newest film.
Oh.
And I hear she's brilliant. And she's also brilliant in everything she does.
Yes.
Father of the Bride, Cleopatra, not to mention The Sandpiper.
The Sandpiper?
I told you not to mention.
I'm sorry.
And what about Little Women?
Huh? Never touch them. If they're too small, you throw them back.
Louisa May Alcott wrote Little Women.
Dan, my uncle wrote Little Girls.
Dick, Little Women was picked up by MGM.
Dan, my uncle was picked up by the FBI.
Dick, you're going to be picked up by the guys in a white coat. Look, you may jest, but Little Women happens to be one of my all-time favorite pictures.
Me too. What a cast. Yeah. June Allison, Margaret O'Brien, Janet Leigh, and Elizabeth as Amy.
Yeah, you'll never see a group like that together again.
No, you'll never see that again, Amy.
Never.
Don't you believe it, Amy. This is your sister, Jo. And your sister, Meg, Amy. I'm here, too.
This is Beth, Amy. Don't forget me.
How could we forget any of you? Any of them, Elizabeth? We've got a little surprise for you.
Yep, just stand back and get ready, because here come the Little Women.
Here's Joe, June Allison.
shotgun.
Oh, wonderful. Great idea.
Here we go.
You got a lot of friends here tonight, Elizabeth, yeah. So we got to keep this show moving right along. Right now, here's a gentleman who's a good friend of yours.
And a really good friend of a friend of Joanne Woodward.
Dick.
Not Dick, Paul. He was her leading man in Cot on a Hot Tin Roof.
That's Cat.
Not in Tarzana.
Ladies and gentlemen, Paul Newman.
Yes.
Well, actually, I'm a little bit embarrassed. I'm not very good at making speeches, and I certainly don't write them. And I have a confession. I sent a tape. It was affectionate and loving. And it was very well written, actually. It was written by Nancy Dowd, who wrote Slapshot. And I found out yesterday that CBS had tampered with this tape and had finagled around with it, so I just came here tonight to find out what they'd done, because I'm severely offended. Roland.
Hi, Elizabeth.
Paul.
I'm sorry I'm not with you tonight, but I am thinking of you and what a time we had making Cat on a Hot Tin Roof. It was one of the best times of my life, and I'll never forget it. All my love, Paul.
No, I think it turned out all right. No, they did leave the best part in, though, which is All My Love.
At table C, one a good friend and another fine actor who wanted to say hello tonight, Broderick Crawford. Brod...
All right, thank you, Tony. I'd like to offer a toast, but I already drank mine. Seeing you tonight, Liz, brings back memories of those wonderful days when you and I did Highway Patrol together. 183 episodes. You don't forget things like that, Liz. I remember it like it was yesterday. 10-3, 10-9, 10-6, whatever, over and in. 10-4.
Better check his car heater. I think it's been on too long. You know, few actors in our profession have achieved such all-around success as the gentleman at table B13, star of Patton, Mr. George C. Scott.
That is. Smoke if you got him. I'll get right to it. Liz, I look around me tonight and I see all these beautiful people here. I can't help but echo the question I think is uppermost in all of our minds, and that is, what the hell are we going to do about the Panama Canal? Thank you. Now, some people say we built it, we bought it, we own it, we'll keep it. But others say we took a hand in their land, built a canal really grand. Now they call it the Perth of the Blues. God bless you.
Truly, truly a lovely tribute to Elizabeth, George.
Elizabeth also here to say hello. At table B1,
Mr. Burt Lancaster.
Oh. Elizabeth, as I look at you, I can't help but be reminded of everyone's favorite films. One of everyone's favorite films, certainly one of mine, Birdman of Alcatraz.
That's funny.
Ah, yes, I'll never forget the immortal words spoken to me by the warden in my cell. Birdman, you've got to get more paper in your cell. You want to see my bird?
You know, Elizabeth, the theme song from one of your films, The Sandpiper, won an Academy Award. Lovely song by Johnny Mandel and Paul Francis Webster, The Shadow of Your Smile. And here to sing it for you and to you, Anthony Newley.
The shadow of your smile. Just before the day,
from a whippoorwill,
when I remember spring, oh, the joy that love can bring, I will be remembering the shadow.
Variety Clubs International is the big heart of show business, and our business is to raise money to help handicapped and underprivileged kids everywhere. Our funds support a variety of projects, from children's hospitals to homes for the retarded, from orthopedic wards to leukemia. Our Sunshine Coach program worldwide provides 1,860 coaches for the transportation of children to camp, outings, therapy, and the like. Our electronic limb program has added a new dimension to prosthetics. From London to Los Angeles, from San Juan to San Francisco, from Sydney to Seattle, 41 chapters in 10 different countries, all helping children. And this year we celebrate our 50th anniversary. In that time, $300 million has been raised to assist needy children throughout the world. Now, last year, because of the funds provided by Sears, a new wing of a children's hospital was made possible, to be known as the John Wayne Wing. And this year, we're proud to select another of our facilities and provide it with the Elizabeth Taylor Wing. I know that Miss Taylor will welcome this manner of tribute, for she has given so much of her time in personal visitations, as well as personal funds to many children's projects in many different countries. This program salutes not only a show business star, but a humanitarian. And that's why Sears and the Variety Clubs International are proud to honor you, Elizabeth Taylor, tonight.
Good evening.
I am delighted to be here tonight to honor a lady I love dearly as a friend and admire greatly as an actress. And an actress she is indeed. She's also someone around whom notoriety seems to gather as bees to honey. Her public image often overshadowing her ability and accomplishments as an actress. Well, it's a fact that Elizabeth's life has provided us all with fascinating reading. Let us not forget that through the years she's also given us marvelous watching and listening up there on the screen. National Velvet, Place in the Sun, Cat on a Hot Tin Roof, Butterfield 8, Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf, all part of a brilliant career spanning 35 years, 50 films, 2 Academy Awards, 5 nominations. You don't get those for walking up the middle aisle a lot. It's very difficult to applaud a lifetime of outstanding work in this one brief interval, but I like to try it. Elizabeth, if you thought that was nice, wait till you hear what we got for you now. Come on with me. We're going to have a little reunion over here. Elizabeth, back in the 40s, when you were just starting, you were working at the MGM studios. And you did some memorable films in those days. And working with you were three young fellows who adored you then and adore you still, and they're with us tonight. Elizabeth, and ladies and gentlemen, from Raintree County, Tom Drake. And from Elizabeth's first film, movie, Lassie Come Home, Roddy McDowell.
Coming through, Elizabeth. was lucky enough to be given an evening like this a year ago, and now I get to kind of pass it on. And once again, I'm in luck because this year, Monty Hall and Mike Frankovich and those wonderful Variety Club people chose to honor Elizabeth Taylor. Now, a lot of you people wonder, how did the Variety Clubs come to choose Elizabeth Taylor to succeed John Wayne? After all, we don't have a lot in common. Elizabeth is rather outspoken. I'm generally very shy. Elizabeth was a child star, and hell, when I was a child, they weren't even making movies. Because of her husband, John, she's now involved in politics, and something that I've never had any interest in. And if I did have an opinion, you know that I would keep it to myself. They wanted to honor someone with one of the most beautiful faces ever to grace the screen, gorgeous body, and a walk that make men tremble. That's what they did last year. So I guess they figured to do the same thing again this year. Well, Liz, you're a good deal more than that. I know you to be a lady of courage, enormous talent, and great compassion for those less fortunate than yourself. And by being here tonight, you're helping the most important people, the most important people in the world, children. We thank you. No awards tonight. No plaques or cups or anything like that. Just the wonderful knowledge that a new wing will be added to a Variety Club hospital in your name. I think you're going to like that. I sure did. So now why don't you come up here so everyone can show you how much they love you.
It's been one of the best nights of my life, at least where a crowd is concerned. What a thrill it is for a farmer's wife from Virginia to be in the room with so many Hollywood celebrities. I know what you're thinking right now. How are you going to keep her down on the farm after she's seen Burbank? Well, I'm a very contented woman these days. As Mrs. John Warner of Middleburg, Virginia, I found a new happiness and a new meaning in my life. And I thank my husband, John. And I thank all of you for being a part of this wonderful evening. John Wayne, I thank you for escorting my John and myself, for sitting with us and your kind remarks. Not since Butterfield 8 have I spent an evening with two such charming Johns. And, well, Billy Carter. I'm so glad he came here with his two shoes on. That was terrific. Well, I'm just so delighted you're all here. You've given not only me, but all the world a lifetime of memories. Bob Hope. Thank you, Paul and Joanne. I don't know, I know how you feel about standing up at one of these affairs, and I'm just doubly blessed that you and Joanne both came here. I feel pretty funny myself about standing up here. And I really do, I thank you both so much for coming here. And I do want to correct some rumor. I was not Paul's dialogue coach on Slapshot. And Henry Fonda, thank you, dear heart, so much. I don't believe half of what you said, but I love you for saying it. And Jimmy and Tom and Roddy, when you three sang Elizabeth, well, it almost brought a tear to my sour notes do have a tendency to do that. But you tried. And Janet Lee, Margaret O'Brien, and June Allison, you lovely little women. Seeing you again means a lot to me. Well, I don't know, I've just kind of run out of things to say. But my love and thanks also to Debbie Boone, Rock Hudson, Robert Blake, Dan and Dick, Frank Gorshwin. It's a thrill to me knowing that this evening will mean much unfortunate children everywhere, and that my name will be associated with the building of a new wing of a children's hospital at the Variety Club. I thank you, Monty Hall, and everybody with the Variety Club, particularly because, as you may know, I'm quite familiar with hospitals, having spent a little time there myself. But the best of them, there are many fine, dedicated hospitals in the world, can never match being in your own home with good, loving people around you. If this evening in some way can do that for someone else, I'm very happy. I love you. And thank you for being here tonight. Just thank you.
To you by Sears Roebuck and Company. From the Atlantic to the Pacific, the Sears family all over America is ready to serve you at a Sears store or through the catalog. Sears is where America shops.